Welcome to Blog Talk Radio. Please hold and you will be able to listen to the show.
Yeah, the 26th sabbatical study for this Shabbat strong. Yes. Now we have some technicals, you know, but it seems like some of these things, you know, are past, so we're just going to move forward right here. So here we have the reading from HaTorah, also the additional reading for the Shabbat HaChodesh. So we're going to reason a little bit on the Shabbat HaChodesh. What does it mean? Why is it really important? Considering the time and the season, the reason for the season right here. So here, first thing first, on the first day, hallelujah. So here, for the Shabbat HaChodesh. Now the Chodesh HaAbib. Chodesh, the new month HaAbib, of Abib. Abib is the first month according to HaTorah. Not many of the months have names, but the first month is given that name in HaTorah, the month of Abib. We have this in Exodus chapter 12, verses 1 to 2. These verses here mean that this month, this moon, should be counted first. And beginning with it, the count should proceed to the second, the third, and so on till the end of the sequence with the 12th moon, the 12th month. In this way, this month should be a commemoration, a memorial of the great miracle, namely, I and Yisrael's redemption. And every time we mention the moons, the month, the miracle will be pointed to, will be alluded to within the order. The first moon right here, first month, this is the time, the reason for the season. And it is for that reason that the months do not have names in HaTorah. We'll note that, with the exception of this first one, Abib. Abib, modern Hebrew, they would say Aviv, like Tel Aviv. Well, Aviv or Abib is like the barley, referring to the barley harvest. And in the royal Amharic, the Ethiopic, we have the Abebe to flower, and Abeba, like a flower, the Adis Abeba, a new flower. So reason for the season, right here. Just a brief overview here on time. The world, the cyclorum, runs on a clock, namely the Gregorian present time. They think to change times and laws. Well, the world runs on a clock that operates under assumptions that are different than those revealed in the scripture, namely in HaTorah. The, quote, wisdom of this world is the prevailing cultural spirit that suppresses and seeks to suppress the reality of Yahweh Eloheinu, his presence, his face, his grace, and the truth. Now, such so-called wisdom is regarded as foolishness lifnei Elohim, before Ha'elohim, before the Elohim of Elohim. And Elohim has promised to, according to 1 Corinthians chapter 3, verse 19, seize the so-called wise in their own craftiness. Now, the life of Emuna, of the Emnet, the Hymenot, the faith, on the other hand, sees what is invisible, what is not visible. Faith, the Emuna, it apprehends the, quote, the substance of things hoped for, the assurance, the conviction, the correction, like to say, like the argument, the hokaha of things not seen. We have this in the Epistle to the Hebrews, chapter 11, verse 1. So as the scripture says, the heart of Emunah, of the Emneh, the Haimanot, the living faith, it looks not to the things that are seen, but to the things that are unseen. For the things that are seen are transient, here today, gone tomorrow, but the things that are unseen are eternal. Here, point of reference, 2 Corinthians chapter 4, verse 18. So here for Shabbat HaChodesh, the reason for the season, the Shabbat that immediately precedes and sometimes occurs on the biblical, the scriptural new year, is called the Shabbat HaChodesh, the Sabbath of the month or the Chodesh. Hebrew sends from the Hadash to new, to make new, to renew, the Sabbath of the renewed, referring to the month, particularly to Abib, this first month Abib, and called in modern times Nisan, after the Babylonian exile, adopting some of the other names, Babylonian names. Sometimes this month is referred to as Nisan, but in HaTorah is referred to as Abib. Now, this Shabbat, the Shabbat HaChodesh, is significant because it marks the start. The start of the month of redemption, which is Abib, Shabbat HaAbib, the month of Abib, the first month that's also called Nisan, that Yahweh Eloheinu, Aina Elohim, called Rosh Chodashim, the head of the new moons, the new months, the beginning of months. So therefore, we honor this event horizon, this time, by reading an additional passage from HaTorah that's concerned with the sanctification or the setting apart, to say the setting apart, the sanctification, the setting apart of the Chodesh, of the new month. According to Exodus chapter 12, Shemot, Exodus chapter 12, verses 1 to 20. And also, we are to spiritually prepare for this Chodesh, this month, by studying about Pesach, Passover, and the coming spring high holy days. So, here the season, coming into the season, that's known as the season of our liberation, the Exodus season, and the commandment, the mitzvah, to sanctify, to set apart the first Chodesh, the first new moon, new month of the year, of the Rosh Chodashim. It reveals that it is our responsibility to sanctify, to observe, to sanctify, to set apart and to observe the biblical, the scriptural time, true time in general. In other words, when we observe the Rosh Chodashim, the head of the months, the beginning of the moons, we are acknowledging that time itself is rooted in the scriptural, in the Torah base, the biblical calendar, with this divinely inspired cycle of the Mo'adim, of the feasts, the festivals, the Mo'adim, the appointments. So note this right here in this year, this season, this time, Pesach, and then the connection with the Shabbat HaChodesh, the Sabbath of the month, the Sabbath of the first of the new month, that this is telling us that Pesach, Passover, is in two Shabuot, in two strong Shabuas, in 2 weeks. Now, note that in this year, this particular period of time, the biblical new year, it begins on the Monday, second day of the Shabuah, April 8th at sundown. And therefore, Pesach, so looking at when the new month, the Rosh Chodashim, begins, then we calculate Pesach. And this year, this time, this season, Pesach Passover begins exactly 2 weeks later. So therefore, in this particular 2024 time and season, new month beginning Monday, April 8th. Interesting. Monday, April 8th, and with the eclipse and all of this and that. But don't be dismayed. Learn not the ways of the heathen, the Goyim. Don't be dismayed at the signs of the heavens. But just interesting, the new months for Abib, the Rosh Chodashim, the beginning of the Hebrew, the churchical, the ecclesiastical, the Torah-based year right here, with Monday, April 8th at sundown. And then Pesach, 2 weeks forward, 2 weeks later, Monday, April 22nd at sundown. Now, originally, Rosh Chodashim, Rosh means head, it's like to say the first, the head of Chodashim, of the moons or the new, literally it's the new referring to the new month, the new moon. So originally Rosh Chodashim, the beginning of months, was simply called the first month because it marked the month of the Yetziat, called Exodus, the month of the Exodus. And the other months were named in relation to the Rosh Chodashim, to the Chodesh Ha'Aviv, similar to the days of the Shavua, the days of the seven, the days of the strong, called the week. In the Hebrew calendar, we have the first day, second day, third day, fourth day, fifth day, sixth day, and then we have the Shabbat day. So later, Rosh Chodashim was called and referred to as Chodesh Ha'Abib, the month of Abib, the springtime month, because the calendar is reset. The Hebrew calendar is reset in the spring. And still later on, this month was referred to as Nisan, to recall how Yahweh Eloheinu, Aina Elohim's, his faithfulness after the Babylonian exile, Nehemiah chapter 2, verse 1, Esther chapter 3, verse 7. So important is this moon, this month, that many of the Yehudi Judaic sages, like one Rebbe Moshe ben Nachman Ramban, had wrote regarding the commandment to observe Rosh Chodashim that we shared a little bit earlier, referring to Exodus chapter 12, focus verses 1 and 2. Now, what about the latter name? In other words, the Torah calls this month Abib. And we have Abib and the Abebe and the Abeba, Adis Abeba, new flower. Abib is the barley. You know, it's the barley, say, crop that grows fast. It's the first of the growing of the crops. Therefore, this springtime season, named in connection with that particular flower, that particular growth, Abib. But then later on, after the Babylonian exile, right? Nehemiah chapter 2, verse 1, Esther chapter 3, verse 7, we get the connection with the name Nisan. Now, the word Nisan, some say, looking at this term from the Babylonian exile that was brought into the equation, that the word Nisan, some say, might come from the Hebrew word or term Nitzan. So we have Nisan. And some speculate that it comes from the Hebrew word nitzan. So Nisan and nitzan. Nitzan means to bud. The meaning of it is like bud, like a bud, right? We have in Song of Songs, Shir HaShirim of Shlomo, Song of Songs of Solomon, chapter 2, verse 12. Or others suggest Nisim, that Nisan is related to the Hebrew word Nisim, meaning miracles. Both of these suggest physical as well as spiritual resurrection, physical and spiritual resurrection in our lives and our liberty is suggested by these two words in relation to Nisan. Nisan, bud, Song of Songs 2 and 12, and Nisim, miracles. Now, others think that the word Nisan, it comes from the Hebrew verb nous, the Hebrew verb nous, meaning to flee, nous, to flee, both in relation to Yisrael's flight from the Tawi, the two lands, from Mitzrayim, ancient Egypt, and the Tawi, ancient Egypt, Mitzrayim's flight from Yisrael. Namely, when the pursuing Mitzrayim cavalry, when they fled, Nisim, before the sea closed upon them in Exodus chapter 14, verses 25 and 27. Now, we also can see this usage in the verb in particular, where we have that in Proverbs chapter 28, verse 1, where it reads, the wicked nasu, flee, the wicked nasu, they flee when no one pursues, but the righteous are bold as a lion. Hasatan, the satanic, the adversary, diablos, power, is found in the lie. The devil Hasatan's so-called power is found in the lie. If he can make you, I and I afraid, then you, I and I will not think clearly. Establishing your faith, emuna haimanot, living faith in the truth, will embolden you and I to deal with the lie and distortions that are intended to enslave you and I in fear. As Ha'adon Adonenu Yeshua HaNotri, as Jesus of Nazareth said, the truth will set you free. I have this in Yohanan, John's Gospel, John chapter 8, verse 32. So here, in this reason for the season here, the biblical scriptural new year, particular key word, Exodus chapter 12, verse 2. Ha-chodesh hazeh lakem, rosh chodashim, rishon hu lakem, le-chadeshei ha-shana, le-chadeshei ha-shana. This month shall be for you, to you, to y'all, the beginning of months, the beginning of moons. It shall be the first month, the first moon of the year for you all, for y'all. Ha chodesh hazeh, ha chodesh, the new month, hazeh, this new month, ha chodesh hazeh, lakem. Lachem, to you all, Rosh Chodashim, the beginning of months, the head of the moons, Rosh Chodashim, Rishon, the first it is, Lachem, to you all, Lichadeshe Hashana. The first month, the renewed of the year, of the Shana. So here, significance of this right here, as well as a baraka right here, the Rosh Chodesh blessing, baraka. So the new moon of Abib, according to the Torah, also known as Nisan, is the most significant of the new moons, the new months of the Hebrew, the Torah-based calendar, since it initiates the first month of the biblical, the scriptural, the Torah-based calendar, and therefore represents the biblical New Year's Day. biblically, scripturally, Torah-wise, the New Year's Day. Of all the various Rosh Chodesh, New Month celebrations, then Rosh Chodesh Abib, Rosh Chodesh Nisan, is foundational, centered, presents the starting point of the cycle of the yearly Mo'adim, the yearly feasts, Mo'adim festivals, Mo'adim appointments that reveal prophetic truths about Yahuwah Elohei Yisrael, Jehovah, the Elohim of Yisrael, and his beloved son, Yeshua HaMoshiach, Baruch Hu, Yeshua the Messiah, blessed be he. Here is a simple baraka, blessing, that you and I can recite to mark this special time. The English of this right here. May it be your will, Yahuwah, our Elohim and the Elohim of our fathers, our ancestors, our patriarchs, that you renew for us, for I and I, a good month in our Master, Yeshua, the Messiah. Amen. Yehi ratzona mi'alifaneka, Yahuwah Eloheinu, ve'Elohei Aboteinu, she'techadesh aleinu. Chodesh Tov Ba Adonenu Yeshua HaMoshiach. Amen. May it be your will, Yehi Ratzon. May it be your will, Yehi Ratzon Milifaneka, from before your presence, Yahuwah, O He who be, we be Eloheinu, our Elohim. Ve Elohei Aboteinu, and the Elohim of Aboteinu, our patriarchs, ancestors, forefathers, She'techadesh, that you renew Aleinu, up on us, for us, Chodesh Tov, a good month, a good moon, Chodesh Tov, Ba'adoneinu, in our Adon, in our Master, Yeshua, HaMoshiach. Amen. L'shana tova ba Mashiach, to a good year in Messiah. And here, just lastly but not leastly, L'shana tova ba Mashiach, for a good year in the Messiah. Following tefillah, prayer, is customarily said during the holiday of Rosh Hashanah, but it is equally applicable for the new year of Abib, for the Rosh Chodashim, and for the season of Pesach, the season of Passover. In English, may it be your will, Yahuwah, our Elohim and Elohim of our fathers, our patriarchs, our ancestors, that you renew for us a good and sweet year in our sovereign Yeshua HaMoshiach. Yehi ratzon milifaneka, Yahuwah Eloheinu, ve'Elohei Aboteinu, she'techadesh aleinu, shana tova, umatuka, ba'adoneinu, Yeshua HaMoshiach. Amen. May it be your will, Yehi ratzon milifaneka, from before your face. May be the will from before your presence in your face. Yehi ratzon milifaneka, Yahuwah Eloheinu, He who be, we be, our Elohim, ve'Elohei Aboteinu, and the Elohim of our patriarchs, our forefathers, our ancestors, Shetechadesh, that you renew Aleinu, on us, for us, Shana Tova, a good year, Shana Tova, U Metuka, and Metuka, a good year, Tova, U and Metuka, and sweet, Badoneinu, Badoneinu in Ainai Sav and Ainai Master, Yeshua HaMoshiach, Yeshua the Messiah. Amen. 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 Hear, hear, hear. Reason for the season. You know, so the Shana Torah. Shana Torah Ba Mashiach. A good year in the Messiah.
Them mostly things that them can't stop me from sin.
Cause I saw the light, no more in darkness. Bless that put me in the light.
Yeah. One man me fear of the Messiah. Me a boy believe in a prayer. Me step on the battlefield without no steel. All when set a fire, all when me numb, no food, no water. The love me never yet shatter. Me a thought is real, the pain me a feel. Them a kill with some vendetta. Yeah. So we basket not empty. Enough time them try to tempt me. Must it show me a lead by far and them see. Them team up and a sign and a tie stop me time from me make me empty. But a one man me fear of the father. Me a boy believe in a prayer. Me step on the battlefield without no shield. All when set a fire. All when me numb, no food, no water. The love me never yet shatter. Me a thought is real of the pain me a feel. Them a kill with.
Say what you want, say what you feel. Me no best friend, so we coulda never deal. Real, when me try stop the meal. Seems like you a send me to the battlefield. Press what you want, press, and you a steal. Run what you want, run, and you a wheel. Then straight up, then I coulda what you feel. Man a soldier, so me coulda never kneel.
One man me fear of the Messiah. Me a boy believe in a prayer. Me step on the battlefield without no steel. All when set a fire, all when me know.
So we basket not empty. Enough time them try to tempt me. Must it show me a lead by far and them see. Them team up and a sign and a tie stop me time from me make me empty. But a one man me fear of the father.
Me a boy believe in a prayer. Me step on the battlefield without no steel. All when set a fire. All when me numb, no food, no water. The love me never yet shatter. Me a thought is real of the pain me a feel. Them a kill with some vendetta.
One man me fear of the Messiah.
Me a boy believe in a prayer. Me step on the battlefield without no steel. All when set a fire. All when me numb, no food, no water. The love me never yet shatter. Me a thought is real of the pain me a feel. Them a kill with some vendetta.
Psalm 24. The earth is the Lord's and the fullness thereof, the world and they that dwell therein. For he hath founded it upon the seas and established it upon the floods. Who shall ascend into the hill of the Lord, or who shall stand in his holy place? He that hath clean hands and a pure heart, who hath not lifted up his soul unto vanity, nor sworn deceitfully. He shall receive the blessing from the Lord, and righteousness from the God of his salvation. This is the generation of them that seek him, that seek thy face, O Jacob. Selah. Lift up your heads, O ye gates, and be ye lift up, ye everlasting doors, and the King of glory shall come in. Who is this King of glory? The Lord strong and mighty, the Lord mighty in battle. Lift up your heads, O ye gates, even lift them up, ye everlasting doors, and the King of glory shall come in. Who is this King of glory? The Lord of hosts. He is the King of glory. Selah. 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 Selah.
מזמור כ"ד לדוד מזמור לאדוני הארץ ומלואה בבל ויושבה, כי הוא על ימים יסדה, ועל נהרות יכונניה. מי יעלה בהר אדוני, ומי יקום במקום קודשו? נקי חפיים ובר לבב, אשר לא נשא לשב נפשי, ולא נשבע למרמה. יישא ורחם את אדוני, וצדקה מאלוהי ישעו. זה דור דורשיו, מבקשי פניך יעקב סלע. שאו שערים ראשיכם, והנשאו פתחי עולם, ויבוא מלך הכבוד. מי זה מלך הכבוד? אדוני עזוז וגיבור, אדוני גיבור מלחמה. שאו שערים ראשיכם, ושאו פתחי עולם, ויבוא מלך הכבוד. מי הוא זה מלך הכבוד? אדוני צבאות, הוא מלך הכבוד, סלע.
לדוד מזמור, לאדוני הארץ ומלואה, בבל ויושבה, כי הוא על ימים יסדה, והנהרות יכונניה, מי יעלה בהר אדוני, מי יקום במקום קודשו, נקי כפיים ובר לבב, אשר לא נשא לשווא נפשי, ולא נשבע למרמה, יישא ורחם את אדוני, וצדקה אלוהי ישעו. זה דור דורשיו, מבקשי פניך יעקב סלע, זהו שערים ראשיכם, ינשאו פתחי עולם. ויבוא מלך הכבוד, מי זה מלך הכבוד? אדוני עזוז וגיבור, אדוני גיבור מלחמה, זהו שערים ראשיכם, ושאו פתחי עולם. ויבוא מלך הכבוד, יהיו זה מלך הכבוד, אדוני צבאות, הוא מלך הכבוד סלע.
Shavua Tov, a good seven, good strong. Sabbatically speaking, yes, I. Shalom, Chavarim, shalom. Give thanks.
Stay tuned for the Haftarah and the Brit HaChadash Aliyot.
Baruch Atah Adonai Eloheinu Melech HaOlam. אשר בחר בנביאים טובים ורצח בדבריהם הנאמרים באמת. ברוך אתה, אדוני, הבוחר בתורה ובמשה עבדו ובישראל עמו ובנביאי האמת והצדק. Blessed art thou, אדוני, אלוהינו, eternal king, who has chosen good prophets and was pleased with their words that were uttered with truth. Blessed art thou, Adonai, who chooses the Torah and Moses, his servant, and Israel, his people, and the prophets of truth and righteousness.
Hear, O Israel. Hear, O Israel.
Shema Yisrael, Adonai Eloheinu, Adonai Echad.
2 Samuel, chapter 6, verse 1, to chapter 7, verse 17.
And again, that we gather together all the chosen men of Israel, 30,000. And that we arose and went with all the people that were with them from Baale of Yehuda, to bring up from thence the Ark of Elohim, whose name is called by the name of Yahweh Zabaot, that dwelleth between the cherubim. And they set the Ark of Elohim upon a new cart and brought it out of the house of Abinadab that was in Gibeah. And Uzzah and Ahio, the sons of Abinadab, drove the new cart, and they brought it out of the house of Abinadab, which was at Gibeah, accompanying the Ark of Elohim, and Ahio went before the Ark. And Dawid and all the house of Israel played before Yahweh on all manner of instruments made of fir wood, even on harps and on psalteries and on timbrels and on cornets and on cymbals. And when they came to Nachon's threshing floor, Uzzah put forth his hand to the Ark of Elohim and took hold of it, for the oxen shook it. And the anger of Yahweh was kindled against Uzzah, and Elohim smote him there for his error. And there he died by the Ark of Elohim. And Dawid was displeased because Yahweh had made a breach upon Uzzah, and he called the name of the place Perez Uzzah to this day. And Dawid was afraid of Yahweh that day and said, "How shall the Ark of Yahweh come to me?" So Dawid would not remove the Ark of Yahweh to him into the city of Dawid, but Dawid carried it aside into the house of Obed-Edom the Gittite. And the Ark of Yahweh, Buruku, continued in the house of Obed-Edom the Gittite 3 months, and Yahweh blessed Obed-Edom and all his household. And it was told in the booth Dawid, saying, "Yahweh, Buruku, has blessed the house of Obed-Edom and all that pertaineth to him, because of the Ark of Elohim." So Dawid went and brought up the Ark of Elohim from the house of Obed-Edom into the city of Dawid with gladness. And it was so that when they that bear the Ark of Yahweh had gone 6 paces, he sacrificed oxen and fatlings, and Dawid danced lifting Yahweh before Yahweh with all his might, and Dawid was girded with a linen ephod. So Dawid and all the house of Israel brought up the Ark of Yahweh, Guruku, with shouting and with the sound of the trumpet. And as the Ark of Yahweh came into the city of Dawid, Akal, Shaul's daughter, looked through a window and saw the goose Dawid leaping and dancing before Yahweh, and she despised him in her heart. And they brought in the Ark of Yahweh and set it in its place in the midst of the tabernacle that Dawid had pitched for it. And Dawid offered burnt offerings and peace offerings to Yahweh, for Yahweh. And as soon as Dawid had made an end of offering burnt offerings and peace offerings, he blessed the people in the name of Yahweh Zabaoth to the king. And he dealt among all the people, even among the whole multitude of Israel, as well to the women as men, to everyone a cake of bread and a good piece of flesh and a flagon of wine. So all the people departed, everyone to his house. Then Dawid returned to bless his household, and Michal, the daughter of Shaul, came out to meet Dawid and said, "How glorious was the king of Israel today, who uncovered himself today in the eyes of the handmaid of his servants, as one of the vain fellows shamelessly uncovered himself." And Dawid said to Michal, "It was before Yahweh Lifnei Yahweh, which chose me before thy father and before all his house to appoint me ruler over the people of Yahweh, over Israel. Therefore will I play before Yahweh, and I will yet be more vile than thus, and will be base in my own sight. And of the maid servants which thou hast spoken of them shall I be had in honor. Therefore my the daughter of Shaul had no child the day of her death." Chapter 7, verse 1 to 17. And it came to pass when the goose sat in the house and Yahweh had given him rest round about from all his enemies, that the king said to Nathan the prophet, "See now, I dwelleth in the house of cedar, the ark of Elohim dwelleth within curtains." And Nathan said to the goose, "Go, do all that is in thine heart, for Yahweh is with thee." And it came to pass that night that the word of Yahweh came to Nathan, saying, "Go and tell my servant Dawit, thus saith Yahweh, shall thou build me a house for me to dwell in? Whereas I have not dwelt in any house since the time that I brought up the children of Israel out of Egypt, even to this day, but have walked in a tent and in a tabernacle, in all the places wherein I have walked with all the children of Israel, the Bani Israel, like I have worked with any of the tribes of Israel, whom I commanded to feed my people Israel, saying, why build ye not me a house of cedar? Now therefore so shalt thou say to my servant Dawit, thus saith Yahweh Zebaoth, I took thee from the sheep coat, from following the sheep to be ruler over my people Israel, and I was with thee wheresoever thou wentest, and have cut off all thine enemies out of thy sight, and have made thee a great name like to the name of the great men that are in the earth. Moreover, I will appoint a place for my people Israel, and will plant them that they may dwell in a place of their own and move no more. Neither shall the children of wickedness afflict them any more, as before time. And since the time that I commanded judges to be over my people Israel, I have caused thee to rest from all thy enemies. Also Yahweh telleth thee that he will make thee a house. And when thy days be fulfilled, and thou shalt sleep with thy fathers, I will set up thy seed after thee, which shall proceed out of thy bowels, and I will establish his kingdom. He shall build a house for my name, and I will establish the throne of his kingdom forever. I will be his father, his Abba, and he shall be my son. And if he commit iniquity, I will chasten him with the rod of men and with the stripes of the children of men. But my mercy shall not depart away from him, as I took it from Shaul, whom I put away before thee. And thine house and thy kingdom shall be established forever before thee. Thy throne shall be established forever. According to all these words, and according to all this vision, so did Nathan speak to Dawit.
House, I eat up on my daily bread. Before I get up, I kneel down at the side of my bed. My spirit led by the blood of Yeshua shed. The scripture says, you gotta be spiritually fed. Out on the ledge, get them all with Haile Selassie, I pled. Open up a new page, open up a new egg. Time for the final plague, time for the end of day. Set to the sun our way, recognize the plan. In the hand of the foreign man in a foreign land. Look at my hand, my golden tan is melanin. And in this land, you hate it beside a Canaanite. Amalekites and Amorites, but Yah's delight is the well-being of the Israelites. Now it's time to get it right, get it while I spit it tight. Always ask the spirit to lead. Let me dig into these scriptures while I'm puffing on weed. Smoke. Mothers teaching babies to twerk, they on that COVID shit. They trying to keep the baby daddy away, I hope the hope gets hit. They gotta raise princesses to get them ready for different instances. Good and evil gotta show what the difference is. Many times why shows what the inference is. The witnesses never changes the emphasis. And what this is, food for your thoughts and intestines. Nourished by the herbal, the cannabis, I keep it verbal, like purple. But I say in the high water's not purple. The water's above, the water's below, the earth is not a globe, it's still a circle. Lift up the girdle and see the earth is still fertile. Jump over mountains like it's a hurdle.
Haftarah and the Brit Hadash Aliyot. Aliyot. Aliyot.
Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu Melech Ha'olam. Asher Natan Lanu Moshiach Yeshua Wehabaruch Shel Habarik Ha Hadasha. Baruch atah Adonai Notain Habarik Ha Hadasha. Blessed are you, Lord, our God, King of the universe, who gave to us the Messiah, Jesus, and the commandments of the new covenant. Blessed are you, Lord, giver of the new covenant.
Hear, O Israel. Hear, O Israel.
Shema Yisrael, Adonai Eloheinu, Adonai Echad.
The Brit Chadasha Chadish Kidan Renewed Covenant reading for RSS number 26, Shemini, 8th. From the book of Hebrews, chapter 8, verse 1 through 6. We begin, B'Shem Ha'ab, V'Habin, V'Ruach HaKadosh, Yahweh Ahad. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, He who be, who he be, the one. Hebrews chapter 8. Because the Aaronic priests serve the shadows of that Mashiach, of that Christ, serves the realities. Now of the things that we have spoken, this is the sum. We have such a high priest, who is set on the right hand of the throne of the majesty in the heavens. Wezeh Rosh HaNe'amarim Sheyesh Lanu Kohen Gadol Asher Yashab Limin Kisei Hagdula Bashemayim, a minister of the sanctuary and of the true tabernacle, that Adonai, that the Lord pitched and not man. Wehu Misharet HaKodesh VeHamishkan HaAmiti Asher Konanu Adonai VeLo Adam. For every high priest is ordained to offer gifts and sacrifices, wherefore it is of necessity that this man have somewhat also to offer. Ki Kol Kohen Gadol Hu Mukad Lehakrib minachot uzbachim ve'al kin tarik shegam ze yehitlo ma sheyakrib. For if he were on earth, he should not be a priest, seeing that there are priests that offer gifts according to the law. Ve'hine ilu haya ba'aretz lo haya kohen ki yesh po. HaKohanim, HaMakribim, HaKarabanot, Alfi HaTorah, who serve to the example and shadow of heavenly things, as Moses was admonished of Elohim when he was about to make the tabernacle. For see, saith he, that thou make all things according to the pattern shewed to thee in the mount. Kahanim lidmut weitel hadbarim shebashmaim kasher tiua Moshe b'pau lehakim et hamishkan ki amar alayo kre wa ase hakol b'tavnito asher ata mare bahar. Because Mashiach, because Christ mediates a better covenant, but now has he obtained a more excellent ministry, by how much also he is the mediator of a better covenant that was established upon better promises.
Wata hu kibel sherut meule kipi malat habrit shehu sarsor la asher hukma al habatachot.
Kaburla Kalu, Kaburla Dimtu, Kaburla Chailu, Kaburla Ketamawi, Chaile Selassie, Be Jesus Christos Sim. Glory to word, glory to sound, glory to power. Glory to Abinu Melkenu, our Father, our King, the first power of the Trinity, in the name of Yeshua HaMashiach, Jesus Christ. Yes, I, Rastafari.
We have fulfilled all. Praise be to Mesken, Exiavi, Yemesken, Jesus Christos, Jesus Christos, Jesus Christos, Jesus Christos.
Shabbat Tov, a good seven, good strong. Good
sabbatically speaking, yes, I. Shalom, Chavarim, Shalom. Give thanks.
This is Psalms 24 without apology. Muta Maruka and Luciana. Trust me.
Yes, it's the Lord and the fullness thereof.
The earth is the Lord and the fullness thereof.
Why and they that
the world
therein.
And they that dwell therein. For he had found it upon the sea.
He had born and it on the sea.
And established it upon the flood.
Established it on the flood.
Who shall ascend in the hill of
Jacob?
Or who shall stand in his holy place?
Who shall stand in the holy place?
He that hath clean hands
and
a pure heart.
And heart.
Who hath not lifted up his soul into vanity?
Nor scorned his people.
He hath received the blessing from Jah-Jah and righteousness from the Almighty of his salvation. Generation of them that seek him.
This is a generation that seek him the most high God.
That seek thy face, O Jacob.
Seek thy face, O Jacob.
Lift up your head, O ye gates.
Lift up
and be lifted up, ye everlasting doors. And the King of glory shall come in.
And the King of glory shall come in.
Who is this King of glory?
I say, who?
Emperor Ili Eyes, this last the eye.
Thank you.
יבואו יום יבוא אלה שצוחקים עכשיו יבכו אלה שבוכים עכשיו הם עוד יתחקו ברוך השם יש לנו את האחרות לבחור ממשיך קדימה לא נשאר מאחור הכוח הוא בהתמדה כן ורק בסוף הדרך סופרים את הקופה
מזמור תפגנת, ודוד מזמור, לאדוני הארץ ומלואה, תבל ויוש ורק, כי הוא על ימים יסדה, ועל נהרות יכונניה, מי יעלה בהר אדוני, ומי יקום במקום קודשו, וכי חפיים ובר לבב, אשר לא נשא לשאר נפשי, ולא נשבע למרמה, יישא ורחם מאת אדוני, וצדקה מאלוהי ישעו. זה דור דורשיו מבקשי פניך יעקב סל שאו שערים רעשכם והנשאו פתחי עולם ויבוא מלך הכבוד מי זה מלך הכבוד אדוני עזוז וגיבור אדוני גיבור מלחמה שאו שערים רעשכם ושאו פתחי עולם ויבוא מלך הכבוד מי הוא זה מלך הכבוד אדוני צבאות הוא מלך הכבוד Sela, Sela, Sela.
Hey.
מזמור תת למנצח על מות לבן מזמור לדוד 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 מזמור לדוד
I will praise thee O Lord with my whole heart I will show forth all thy marvelous works I will be glad and rejoice in thee I will sing praise to thy name O thou most high When mine enemies are turned back they shall fall and perish at thy presence For thou hast maintained my right and my cause Thou sattest in the throne judging right. Thou hast rebuked the heathen. Thou hast destroyed the wicked. Thou hast put out their name forever and ever. O thou enemy, destructions are come to a perpetual end, and thou hast destroyed cities. Their memorial is perished with them. But the Lord shall endure forever. He hath prepared his throne for judgment, and he shall judge the world in righteousness. He shall minister judgment to the people in uprightness. The Lord also will be a refuge for the oppressed, a refuge in times of trouble. And they that know thy name will put their trust in thee, for thou, Lord, hast not forsaken them that seek thee. Sing praises to the Lord which dwelleth in Zion. Declare among the people his doings. When he maketh inquisition for blood, he remembereth them. He forgetteth not the cry of the humble. Have mercy upon me, O Lord. Consider my trouble which I suffer of them that hate me, thou that liftest me up from the gates of death, that I may show forth all thy praise in the gates of the daughter of Zion. I will rejoice in thy salvation. The heathen are sunk down in the pit that they made. In the net which they hid is their own foot taken. The Lord is known by the judgment which he executeth. The wicked is snared in the work of his own hands. Higgaiah, Selah. The wicked shall be turned into hell, and all the nations that forget God. For the needy shall not always be forgotten. The expectation of the poor shall not perish forever. Arise, O Lord, let not man prevail. Let the heathen be judged in thy sight. Put them in fear, O Lord, that the nations may know themselves to be but men. Selah, 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 Selah.
White, the eye, don't see it. They have a way to look at you and me, yeah.
Chapter 9. And it came to pass on the eighth day that Moses called Aaron and his sons and the elders of Israel. And he said unto Aaron, Take thee a young calf for a sin offering, and a ram for a burnt offering, without blemish, and offer them before the Lord. And unto the children of Israel thou shalt speak, saying, Take ye a kid of the goats for a sin offering, and a calf and a lamb, both of the first year, without blemish, for a burnt offering. Also a bullock and a ram for peace offerings to sacrifice before the Lord, and a meat offering mingled with oil, for today the Lord will appear unto you. And they brought that which Moses commanded before the tabernacle of the congregation, and all the congregation drew near and stood before the Lord. And Moses said, This is the thing which the Lord commanded that ye should do, and the glory of the Lord shall appear unto you. And Moses said unto Aaron, Go unto the altar, and offer thy sin offering, and thy burnt offering, and make an atonement for thyself and for the people, and offer the offering of the people, and make an atonement for them, as the Lord commanded. Aaron therefore went unto the altar, and slew the calf of the sin offering which was for himself. And the sons of Aaron brought the blood unto him, and he dipped his finger in the blood, and put it upon the horns of the altar, and poured out the blood at the bottom of the altar. But the fat and the kidneys and the caul above the liver of the sin offering he burnt upon the altar, as the Lord commanded Moses. And the flesh and the hide he burnt with fire without the camp. And he slew the burnt offering, and Aaron's sons presented unto him the blood which he sprinkled round about upon the altar. And they presented the burnt offering unto him with the pieces thereof and the head, and he burnt them upon the altar. And he did wash the inwards and the legs, and burnt them upon the burnt offering on the altar. And he brought the people's offering, and took the goat, which was the sin offering for the people, and slew it, and offered it for sin, as the first. And he brought the burnt offering, and offered it according to the manner.
Shalom, Chabarim, shalom. RSS, this week's Torah portion reading and feeding. 26 Torah portion reading and feeding, known as Shemini. Shemini. Many enunciate as Shemini, Shemini, Hashemini, Hashemini. Bayom Hashemini. On the, in the day, the Yom, Ha, the Shemini. In the day of the eighth, in the eighth day, Bayom HaShemini. So we have Shemini, Shemini. This is the 26th reading from HaTorah, from the directions, the instruction, the teaching, gives the teaching of His divine majesty. And here we have the third reading from the third book of Moshe, the Hebrew book that's known as Leviticus. In the Hebrew, we call it the Sefer Vayikra. And he called from the first word of the reading, first reading from this third book. Now here we're at the third reading from the third book of Leviticus, the Orit Ze Lewawiya. In the HSV, the Haile Selassie version, in the Book of the Seven Seals, it's known as the Orit, Orit, Orit. We say Orit, Ethiopically referring to Torah, HaTorah, Orit Ze Lewawiyah. The Torah, the direction, the instructions of the Lewim, Lewawiyah, of the Levites. So now the word Shemini, Shemini, it means eighth, the eighth. Ba Yom HaShemini. We recommend that we refer to it as a HaShemini, because the eighth, but often known as Shemini, Shemini, more correctly pointed, Shemini, Shemini, Bayom HaShemini. Shemini. Shemini. So the first words, it comes from the first words of Leviticus chapter 9, verse 1, Leviticus 9 and 1, which says, "Now it came to pass about on the eighth day by Yom HaShemini that Moshe called, Kara Moshe, Moses called Aharon, Ubanayo, and the Ziknei Israel," the Ziknei Israel, the elders of Israel. So here we have the first words for this third reading here, for the third book of Moses here, the 26th weekly Torah portion reading and feeding and 99 annual Rastafari sabbatical studies, and here for this Shabbat strong, Shemini. Be Simentenyawum Ken. Mamarinya, the Metzav Kedus, the Simentenya, Shemini, Simentenyawum, Be Simentenyawum Ken. On the eighth day. Now, the text, the narrative here goes on to describe the events of Bayom HaShemini, events of the eighth day after setting up HaMishkan, setting up the tabernacle. A phenomenal Phenomen, phenomenal worship service followed. It was followed by a very tragic incident. Now the reading, it concludes here with the biblical Levitary, the Levit, some say the diet, they say the Levit, some say the dietary laws, the Levity laws, the Hebrew, the Old Testament, the Hebrew Levity laws regarding animals fit for consumption and prohibitions regarding those that are unfit. So the kashrut, that which is kashrut or kosher, and that which is not kosher. So here we have this 26 weekly Torah portion reading and feeding in the cycle, the Shana sabbatical cycle of the Torah portion reading and feeding. Shemini, Shemini. Now the portion, the Torah portion commentary right here speaks of the spiritual fire. Menfisawi Issat, the Issat, Mamarinya, the Issat fire, known in the Hebrew as the Aish. The Aish, Aish, some pronounce it and none says Aish, the Aish, Aish, spiritual fire. What is the thought? What is the thought, the Medi, the agitation for the Shabua, for the strong? Thought for this week's Torah portion reading and feeding, then fire came out from before the Yahweh, Mi Alifnei Yahuwah, from before Jehovah, and it consumed the burnt offerings and the portions of the chelev, the fat on HaMizbeach, on the altar. And when all Ha'am and all the people saw it, seen, they shouted and fell on their faces and worshiped. Now, here, this is Leviticus chapter 9. Chapter 9, verse 24. Now, one thing we noticed and observed that was interesting, and hopefully we have a little more, you know, time to wrap and reason on this, is the weight. The weight. And here it was in connection with the psalm, the royal order of the Ethiopian Hebrew psalm in this season, Psalm 130. And that waiting, early in the Shabua, we touched on it, the waiting. The waiting. You see, this Torah reading, it continues from the previous sabbatical reading. Sal, sal, sav, command. Izzacho, command them. We have the seven-day initiation. We refer to it as the initiation, the starting, the initiation. The initiation ceremony. Some refer to it as augury, inauguration. We strike that right there, but the initiation, the starting ceremony for HaMishkan, for the tabernacle, and HaKohanim, and the priests, is described. Now, during each of the 7 days, and what's referred to as the 7 days of consecration, now this is a very interesting word, and note it, make it duly noted, Chabarim, disciples, Machabatenyoch, Wendemoch. Note this right here, disciples, that the word consecration in the Hebrew,
has to do with the filling. The filling and the filling of the hands. So we refer to it often, and often it's referred to as the 7 days of the consecration, 7 days of one will say the ordination, 7 days of inauguration, we say the initiation. But here, the 7 days of consecration refers to the filling of the hands, literally to the filling, the 7 days of filling and fulfilling by Yom HaShemini, fulfilling on the eighth day. So the 7 days of filling, and then on the eighth day, it is fulfilled. So the 7 days of consecration refer to the 7 days of the filling of the hands. Make note, take note, the filling of the hands. Now, some say beginning on Adar the 23rd, Moshe, Moses, he essentially served as the first Kohen Gadol of Israel. How did Moshe essentially, in essence, serve as the first high priest? Moses served as the first high priest of Israel by offering, by way of the offering sacrifices and the training of the new Kohanim, of the new priests. Now, on the eighth day, by Yom HaShemini, however, which some point to as Nisan first, or the Abib, the first of Abib, Ha Elohim, the true good, the true God, commissioned Aharon Ubenayo to officially by HaTorah, by way of HaTorah. What is official? People use the term office, or the office, official, right? By law, according to HaTorah, according to the directions, according to the instructions, according to the teachings, Jah commissioned Aaron and his sons to officially begin their new responsibilities as Yisrael, the Bnei Yisrael's Kohanim, priest, Kahenat. Now, the portion, this Torah portion here first describes the ceremonies, the rites, the rituals performed to consecrate. Right, now here when we speak of the consecration of the altar, right, we have a different word used, right, for consecrate. Let's take note of that. But the consecration, the making set apart of HaMizbeach, the setting apart of the altar. Now, instead of Moshe functioning as the Kohen Gadol, the high priest, Lika Kahenat, Aharon, he brought various offerings, including the chatat, the sin, the akri offering, and ho'olah, the burnt offerings, both for himself and for the ziknei Yisrael, and for the elders of Yisrael. Now, Aharon, Ubenayo, Aaron, and his sons, they then offered additional sacrifices on behalf of Ha'am, on behalf of the people, on behalf of Jah people as well. Now, after completing the sequence, the cycle and the sequence, the order of the offerings, Aharon, he blessed Ha'am, he blessed Jah people with the Berkat HaKohanim, what is known as the priestly burake, the priestly blessing. However, the Kabodi Yahuwah, the Kabodi Jehovah, the glory of Jehovah did not appear. And there was no divine fire. There was no Aish. There was no Issat. There was no fire. Now, some refer to the fire as the Shekinah, right? And now, let's point this out here, right? That consumed the offering, there was no fire. We get into the reasoning on the Shekinah and the Shekinah, 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 she, referring to she dwelling, and the Shekinah, he who be who he be, Jah, Shekinah, Jah dwelling. Right? But here we're speaking about this anxious moment. There was this anxious moment, a very anxious moment for Ha'am, a very anxious moment for Jah people. Ain't nothing new under the sun. There was an anxious moment for Jah people because all had been done according to Torah according to the directions and the instructions, but there was no divine Aish. There was no Aish. There was no fire. There was no fire. The Shekinah, in other words, did not consume the sacrifices. So we have the glory, right? We have two things here, two items here. Let's point it out like this. We have the glory, the Kabodi Yahuwah, the glory of Jehovah, and we have the divine fire to consume the sacrifices. So here was a very anxious moment. This is what brought to mind Psalm 130. And the use and the speaking of the words for wait and hope, the waiting and hoping. This is when wait and hoping is important, right? The expectation. What do you expect? There was an anxious moment. They expected the glory, the Kabod Yahuwah of Jehovah. They expected the Aish, the fire, but there was none. It did not appear. So this anxious moment for Ha'am, for Jah people, since it was unclear. See, why this moment was so anxious is because it was unclear. It was unclear to Jah people whether Jehovah had accepted, whether he had accepted Aharon's offerings. You see, why is that important? Because if Jehovah did not accept Aharon's offering, that would mean to the people that they had not been forgiven. They had not been forgiven, that Yisrael had not been forgiven the sin of what is called and referred to as the, quote, golden calf, end quote. It's kind of interesting right there. You know, the Igel Masecha, the molten calf, the Fukuri, the Ukuri, the sin, the lack. They were caught majorly lacking. And Aharon as well is implicated in this particular incident. So here we have this anxious moment for the people, right? And the lack of clarity as to whether Yahuwah Jehovah had accepted Aharon's offerings and therefore had forgiven Yisrael, the Bnei Yisrael, the sons, the children of Israel, for the Chat'at, the Chat'iyat, the sin, the Ukuri, the Ephri of the molten calf, referred to and called the golden calf. More correctly, the molten calf, the Igel Masecha. Now Moshe, here's where Moshe and Aharon, then they went in. They had to go in. They went in. Moshe and Aaron, they went in to the holy place of the Mishkan, into the holy place of the Mishkan, and interceded. And after they came out to bless Ha'am, to bless Jah people again, then, and only then, did the Kabodi Yahuwah, the Kabodi Yahweh, the glory of Jehovah appeared, and the holy fire, the Aish, fire, in the form of a lion. See, tradition says the fire came forward in the form of a lion and consumed the offerings on HaMizbeach, while all the people saw it, seen, sight, they rejoiced at it, and they shouted, and they fell on their faces, they prostrated, they worshipped, they gave thanks and praise, because now they knew that Aharon, their high priest, the first high priest. Actually, he's the first high priest, Moshe. He served as the first high priest for the initiation, for the filling, right, and the fulfilling, right, of the rites and rituals concerning the consecration, the filling of the hands. Keep that word in mind for the consecration in regard to the consecration of the priests, of the Kohanim. It refers in the Hebrew to the filling of the hands, literally to the filling of the hands. So the 7 days of the filling, the 7 days of the filling of the hands, coming to Shemini, Yom HaShemini, to the 8th day, the fulfillment. This Torah portion here. Now, this Torah portion, it continues. Right, now, after that, good news. Remember, all of this occurred. All this occurred on this same day, on the eighth day. Now, let's think and consider, right? 6 days, so you do all your work, and the seventh day is Yom HaShabbat. So what is the eighth day? Isn't this interesting? The eighth day, right? That first day, the first day, the first day, the resurrection day, the first day. But the portion before we move forward, let us just give thanks and praise, right? That the glory of Yahuwah, of Jehovah, came forward, the divine fire, as tradition says, in the form of the lion. The divine fire came forward from the ark, from the holy place, right? Some say the ark, the altar of incense, from within the Mishkan, right? To consume the offerings that were upon HaMizbeach, the brazen altar. In the outer court, 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 in the outer court.
Shavua Tov, a good seven, good strong. Good
sabbatically speaking, yes, I. Shalom, Chavarim, shalom. Give thanks.
And there came a fire out from before the Lord, and consumed upon the altar the burnt offering and the fat, which when all the people saw, they shouted and fell on their faces. Chapter 10. And Nadab and Abihu, the sons of Aaron, took either of them his censer, and put fire therein, and put incense thereon, and offered strange fire before the Lord, which he commanded them not. And there went out fire from the Lord, and devoured them, and they died before the Lord. Then Moses said unto Aaron, This is it that the Lord spake, saying, I will be sanctified in them that come nigh me, and before all the people I will be glorified. And Aaron held.
Slice shit is like bump the fuck out, for real. Suffer. To survive, well, that's to find meaning in the suffering.
Hey, yo, I'm slipping, I'm falling, I can't get up. Hey, yo, I'm slipping, I'm falling, I can't get up. Hey, yo, I'm slipping, I'm falling, I got to get up. Get back on my feet so I can cast it up. Hey, yo, I'm slipping, I'm falling, I can't get up. Hey, yo, I'm slipping, I'm falling, I can't get up. Hey, yo, I'm slipping, I'm falling, I got to get up. Get back on my feet so I can cast it up.
Here, Shema Yisrael, here, O Israel. This Torah portion here, the 26th sabbatical study for this Shabbat strong, Ha Shemini, the eighth, speaking of the eighth day. So what we have here is the consecration, we could say the filling, literally, directly, the filling of the hands, the consecration of the Kohanim, and the initiation of the Kahuna, the consecration of the priests, the sons of Aharon, Aaron as the high priest, the anointed, and his sons, Banav, his sons, more of the ancient pointing of the Hebrew, Banayo, Aharon u Banayo, Aaron and his son. So here we have the consecration, thus the significance of the title for the 26th sabbatical study from the key word Ha Shemini. Besamentenyawim Ken on the eighth day. So here, just to bring out the Midrash, we have Psalm 75. And in the Midrash Tehillim, the study of the Tehillim, the Psalter, we have this comment here in the second parak, the second section,
where Psalm 75, Hebraically the fifth verse, is brought out that reads in part, I say to the wicked, you shall not lift up the horn. Hear, 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 Psalm 75, Hebraically the fifth verse. Now, how does this connect right here and the four great joys, the four great joys that in one day Elisheba, she knew four great joys. So the pointing to Psalm 75.2, the second parek, the sheni parek, parek sheni, the second section of the study of Psalm 75 brings this out right here, here, here. Second paragraph, it says, according to Harebanim, this verse, the fuller verse from Psalm 75, I say to the arrogant, you shall not deal arrogantly, and to the wicked, you shall not lift up the horn. What does this verse allude to, and why do Harebanim, the rabbis, the ancient scholars of Torah, the Memheran, why do they say this alludes to Elisheba? And here, 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 Mizmor Ein Hey, Psalm 75, that's themed the nation's gratitude. Here, the Hey verse, the fifth verse, Hebraically, that reads, Amarti laholim al taholu willa rishaim al tarimu karen, lift not up the horn. I say to the arrogant, I say, amarti, I say, I say, because I have said, amarti, la holalim, to the holalim, al taholu, deal not arrogantly. And here, 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 according to the KJV, the King James Version, it'll be the fourth verse in the KJV, not including the superscription, which is the first verse. So in KJV, King James Version, Psalm 75, verse 4, it reads, I said to the fools, amarti laholim, deal not foolishly, al taholu, deal not foolishly, and to the wicked, willa rishaim, and to the ratchet, willa rishaim, lift not up the horn, al tarimu, karen, don't y'all lift up, karen, don't lift up the horn. So here we have arrogant, and here we have foolish and fools. Halal. Halal is an interesting, very, very interesting word, right? Because in the PL, Hebraically, the grammar in Hebrew, this word can mean to praise, to boast. Where we say, the ilil, bamarinya, ilil. And then we have halal, the hey, not the chet, not halal, but halal. So here's what the ililta, where we say tehillim, the praises, the ilil. The praise, the exaltation, the boasting, to make a boast. In the pu'al sense of the verb, to be praised. Mihulal, to be praised. The pu'al, mihulal, to be praised, to be made praiseworthy, to be commended, to be worthy of praise. In the hitpa'al sense of the verb is to boast, to glory, to make one's boast. But in the po'el sense of the verb, it is to make a fool of, make into a fool. Now, this is interesting because there's many senses of the ililta, That's not always praise of he who be, who he be, HaKadosh, Baruch Hu, Baruch Hashem, the Holy One, blessed be he, blessed be the name, but it's also can be used in a mocking sense, right? And now what's interesting is when HaSatan, right, the one that they call the Latin Lucifer, according to the prophets, fell, his name, Hallel, right, Hallel ben Shachar, right, the so-called son of the morning, right, has his sense, right? So it can be used to praise one, or in a sense where one has been made a fool of, or one that does this is really boasting in an arrogant sense, to make a fool of. So the heat poel sense, that's a buildup of the poet, of the poel sense of the verb is to make a fool of, the heat poel, to act madly, to act like a madman. So here where it says amarti, laho lalim, right, to the arrogant, the foolish, mad ones, al taholu, don't act like a madman, don't act foolishly. But now we get to the root of the word halal, the H1984, according to the Strong's, and it means in the first sense to shine, to be clear, the primitive root to be clear. It's originally used of sound, to be clear of sound, but also it's used of color, right, to shine, hence to make a show, that is to say, to boast. Thus to be foolish, and thus to be foolish in a clamorous sense, also to rave. In a causative sense is to celebrate. So when we do this for he who be, who he be, we celebrate. But it can also have the sense to stultify, to make boast, to boast self, to celebrate. One can celebrate he who be, who he be, or celebrate themselves. So here's a sense where the foolish sense to commend, right? One can commend one who's commendable, or they can commend themselves. Thus, to deal, to make fool, to be fools, to be foolish. What also has a sense of to give glory, to give light, but to be or to make, to feign self mad, right? Another archaic sense to give in marriage, right, in a singular sense, right, to be worthy of praise, but to rage, to renown, to shine. So it's a very interesting word right here, the twofold sense. There's two edges, right, to the sword of this word here, halal. One is to shine in the figurative sense of ha'elohim's favor. The hefil sense is to flash forth light, to praise, to boast, to be boastful, right? But in the sense of the holalim, the boasters, right? The fools, right? Those who are mad. So this is the context right here in Psalm 75. According to the KJV translation, I said to the fools, deal not foolishly, and to the wicked, lift not up the horn. Or I've said to the arrogant, amarti, la holalim, to ha holalim, la holalim, al taholu, and to the wicked, willa rishaim, lift not up, al tarimu, karen, the horn. So according to HaRebbanim, the Rebbeinot, the scholars of Torah, the ancient rabbis, the Memheran, this verse alludes to Elisheva, the daughter of Aminadab, who in one day knew four great joys. So here, the connection with the 26th sabbatical study, Ha Shemini, and Nadab and Abihu, Shema, Shemu Li, hear this. So Elisheba, the daughter of Aminadab. Now for more on that relationship there, you can turn to Exodus chapter 6, verse 23. Exodus chapter 6, verse 23, Elisheba, the daughter of Aminadab, who in one day knew four great joys. She saw her brother-in-law, Moshe, the head of the fraternal order of Halloween, the Levites, Moses made king. Moses was king. She saw Moshe made king. Her husband, Aaron, made Kohen Gadol, Lika Kahenat, made high priest. Her brother, Nahshon, made prince, Nasi, made prince. And her sons, Eleazar and Ithamar, made adjutants of the high priest, the Kohen Gadol, the Lika Kahenat. But then her two other sons, Nadab and Abihu, went in to make offerings, to offer Aishans, incense, and were devoured by Aish, by fire. As it is written, and here's the connection, Vayikra, Leviticus, and he called Leviticus chapter 10, verse 2, and there came forth fire from before the Lord and devoured them. Watetze eish milifnei Yahuwah, watokal otam, wayamutu lifnei Yahuwah, and there came forth fire. Watetze eish, and she, fire, watetze, she coming forward, Aish, fire, and fire came forth, and she, fire, came forth. Watetze Aish, milifnei, from the face, milifnei, the presence, the perception, before, milifnei Yahuwah, from the presence of he who be who he be, watokal otam, and she ate otam then, and she ate them, watetze eisha milifnei Yahuwah, watokal otam, wayamutu, and they died, yamutu, wa and yamutu, wayamutu, lifnei Yahuwah, and they died before, in the presence of, he who be, who he be, HaKadosh Baruch Hu, Baruch Hashem. And as Leviticus chapter 16, verse 1 reads, after the death of the two sons of Aharon, after the death of the two sons of Aaron, her joy changed to grief. And here we have the Kaf 8, right? We have chapter 16. And Jehovah spoke to Moses, Moshe, after the death of the two sons of Aaron, when they drew near before Yahuwah Jehovah and died. Why daber Yahuwah il Moshe achrei mot shenei b'nei Aharon b'karabatam lifnei Yahuwah wayamutu. And so, the arrogantly righteous have no joy in this world. Only the wicked, only the ratchet rejoice. Hence, I say to the arrogant, you, y'all, shall not arrogantly rejoice. Amarti laholalim, ala taholu. Amarti, amarti, I say, amarti, laholalim, to the arrogant, ala taholu. You shall not arrogantly rejoice. Al taholu. Amarti laholim. Al taholu. So here, let's bring this out. So what is being said here? The attribution of arrogance to Elisha seems unnecessary. What the commentator means to cite right here, is to cite her, Elisha, as an example of the sufferings of Hatzadiki, of the righteous ones. While Harasha, the Rishaim, the ratchet, are at ease, yet the latter, Harishaim, the ratchet, will be punished eventually. So here, second part of the verse. Willa Rishai, Altarimu Karen, and to Harishai, Altarimu, don't lift up Karen, the horn. Altarimu Karen. Now there's a further commentary on Nadav and Abihu. Nadav and Abihu, the sons of Aaron, that were deaded on when they went in presumptuously to offer the Aishans. Further commentary found in the Midrash to Tehillim, to the Psalm 78, in the 18th parak, the 18th section, I'd like to build on as well. In the verse in Psalm 78:54, and he brought them to the border of his sanctuary, to this mountain which his right hand had gotten. Sanctuary here refers to the holy temple. He drove out the nations and nationalities before them and allotted them for an inheritance by line, and made the tribes of Israel to dwell in their tents. According to Psalm 78, he breaks the 55th verse. That is, in the tents of the 31 kings of Canaan. He forsook the tabernacle of Shiloh, the tent that he placed among men, Psalm 78 and 60. Now, both Rav Eliezer and Rav Jose Bar Hanina, they taught the following. Since one verse speaks of the tabernacle of Shiloh, the tent that he placed among men, while another verse speaks of the house of the Lord, of Yahweh, of Jehovah in Shiloh in 1 Samuel 1 and 24. Therefore, the lower portion of the sanctuary in Shiloh must have been built of stones with coverings or goat's hair for a roof. According to Rav Ze'era, the lower portion of the sanctuary in Shiloh was built of boards, since it is called the Tabernacle of Shiloh, and delivered his strength into captivity in Psalm 78:61. His strength was the Ark of the Covenant, the Ark of the Witness, the Tabot, the Aaron, difference. Aharon is Aaron, and Aaron is Ark. The Aaron HaBarit, the Ark of the Covenant. Then we come to verse 63, Hebraically in Psalm 78, connected even with the 26th Torah reading and feeding, Rastafari sabbatical, HaShemini, where it says, the fire devoured their young men. In Psalm 78, the 63rd verse, Hebraically, devoured Nadav and Abihu. Abba Hanin said, Nadab and Abihu were boastful men. Hallelujah. For they said, what woman is worthy of us? What woman is worthy of I and I? We are sons of the Kohen Gadol, of the high priest. Our uncle Moshe is Melech, is king. Our grandfather is a Nasi, is a prince. What woman can possibly be worthy of us, of I and I? Accordingly, the fire devoured their young men. Lamazeh, why? Because their virgins had no marriage song. Why did the fire devour their young men? Because their virgins had no marriage song. Their priests fell by the sword. Psalm 78, Hebraically the 64th verse. That is, Hophni and Pinchas, Phinehas, fell. Yahuwah, Jehovah. Then Adonai will awaken as one out of sleep. Psalm 78, verse 65. Rab Berechiah. Berechiah said in the name of Rav Eliezer, Eliza, before the time the hour of redemption comes, HaKadosh, the Holy One, Baruch Hu, blessed be He, makes Himself out to be asleep. If one may dare speak thus, like this, Adonai will awaken as one out of sleep. Indeed, when the time the hour of redemption comes, Ha'el, Ha'el, Ha'elohim, the true good, the true God, the power will be like a mighty man recovering from wine.
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 For from the rising of the sun, even unto the going down of the same, my name shall be great among the Gentiles. And in every place incense shall be offered unto my name, and a pure offering. For my name shall be great among the heathen, saith the Lord of hosts, saith the Lord of hosts, saith the Lord of hosts, saith the Lord of hosts.
Yeah. Before David Bathsheba, before Solomon Makedah, before Moses Zipporah, Vashti come before Esther, Jah come from Ethiopia. Anything them prime minister within the aptitude of Jah, Omri Ethiopia, in a half angel Michael. Not much how much glad the dragon ha. Them cannot reach the emperor. Confound them Muta Baruka, the holy mountain of Luna. Give away everything for war. As better Israel falasha, as every stroke of amnesia. Now the youth are chantrasta. Family can't buy them no care. So them a innovate raga. Yeah. Yeah. And again. Before David Bathsheba, before Solomon Makeda, before Moses Zipporah, Vashti did come before Esther, Jacob from Ethiopia, anything them prime minister, within the aptitude of Jah, Omri Ethiopia, in a archangel Michael, no matter how much clap them dragon ha. Yeah, here and again, study the earth and figure out Mamala. Too disobedient in a ya. I kill out the earth because of wa. Body used by Lucifer. Spark Rasta man burn the chalawa. Give smoke of offering unto Jah. No bother go jack down your heart in a. Wrong thought you project to your brother. Here and again. As I wa winter left the summer far. I see the vision of the act of Jah, a flaming sword of fire, figure the garden equator, the whole world, this generation, yeah.
I got sight of the emperor. Still I say I give I no power over. Mental illusion in a red drop, drop. Ganja sativa ya indica. Rastaman a ride ya in a canter. I am I stand up whenever. Them try to crush ya and step over. For the one to are in a my gear. Please don't bring that over ya. These are right people, Levi share. Cause Levi share, I want to share. Here and again. Before David Bathsheba, before Solomon Makeda, before Moses Tipora, Vashti come before Esther, Jack come from Haiti, Ophia, anything them prime minister, within the aptitude of ya, Humre Haiti, Ophia, ya in a archangel Michael, Nama too much for them dragon, confound them Muta Baruka. Hey, this is the I bongo over here. Without Vatican interfere, to keep the precept worldly clear. Without scatter out here and there, without stray out here and there. For the love I keep John near, for the truth I keep up here. Yeah. Try make David Kappa disappear in the field, tie out the mirror. And still be seen to so long here. So aggressive out of fear. What else if I learn from Delilah? She shall keep the innocence of Dinah. And them still a fight over. Before David Bathsheba, before Solomon Makeda, before Moses Zipporah, Vashti come before Esther, Jehovah mighty Ophia. Anything that prime minister, within the aptitude of Jah, humble high Ethiopia, Jah in the archangel Michael, no matter how much love them Jah can't touch the emperor, cannot reach the emperor, come from them Muta Baruka.
Almut Laben, Mizmor Ledavi, Mizmor Ledavi, Mizmor Ledavi, Mizmor Ledavi, Mizmor Ledavi, Mizmor Ledavi.
I will praise thee, O Lord, with my whole heart. I will show forth all thy marvelous works. I will be glad and rejoice in thee. I will sing praise to thy name, O thou most high. When mine enemies are turned back, they shall fall and perish at thy presence. For thou hast maintained my right and my cause. Thou sattest in the throne, judging right. Thou hast rebuked the heathen. Thou hast destroyed the wicked. Thou hast put out their name forever and ever. O thou enemy, destructions are come to a perpetual end, and thou hast destroyed cities. Their memorial is perished with them. But the Lord shall endure forever. He hath prepared his throne for judgment, and he shall judge the world in righteousness. He shall minister judgment to the people in uprightness. The Lord also will be a refuge for the oppressed, a refuge in times of trouble. They that know thy name will put their trust in thee, for thou, Lord, hast not forsaken them that seek thee. Sing praises to the Lord which dwelleth in Zion. Declare among the people his doings. When he maketh inquisition for blood, he remembereth them. He forgetteth not the cry of the humble. Have mercy upon me, O Lord. Consider my trouble which I suffer of them that hate me. Thou that liftest me up from the gates of death, that I may show forth all thy praise in the gates of the daughter of Zion. I will rejoice in thy salvation. The heathen are sunk down in the pit that they made. In the net which they hid is their own foot taken.
The Lord is known by the judgment which he executeth. The wicked is snared in the work of his own hands. The wicked shall be turned into hell, and all the nations that forget God. For the needy shall not always be forgotten. The expectation of the poor shall not perish forever. Arise, O Lord, let not man prevail. Let the heathen be judged in thy sight. Put them in fear, O Lord, that the nations may know themselves to be but men. Selah, Selah, Selah.
To the eternal, lanatzeach, al mut, up on death, labain, for the sun, for the sun, mizmor tet, mizmor tet, Psalm 9, mizmor 8, Psalm IX, lanatzeach, al mut labain, mizmor le David, for the leader, for the chief musician, lanatzeach, for the overcomer. Lamnatzeach, to the eternal, lamnatzeach, al mut, up on death, labain, for the son, al mut labain, mizmor le David, a psalm of David, a psalm, a chant, Isis of David, Isis, a psalm of the well-beloved, lamnatzeach, al mut labain, mizmor le David. Odeh Yahuwah, the caller libi, isapra kol nifloteka. I will give thanks to Jehovah with my whole heart. I will tell of all thy marvelous works. Odeh Yahuwah, the caller libi. Odeh, I will give thanks. Odeh Yahuwah, the call with all libi. All my heart. Mizmor tet. Mizmor tet. Mizmor tet. Psalm 9. Mizmor 8. Psalm IX. Lanatzeach al mut labain. Mizmor le David. For the leader, for the chief musician, lanatzeach. For the overcomer, lanatzeach. To the eternal, lanatzeach. Al mut, up on death, labain, for the son, al mut labain, mizmor le David, a psalm of David, a psalm, a chant, Isis of David, Isis, a psalm of the well-beloved, lamnatzeach, al mut labain, mizmor le David. Odeh Yahuwah, the caller libi, isapra caller nifloteka, I will give thanks to Jehovah with my whole heart. I will tell of all thy marvelous works. Odeh Yahuwah, bekol libi. Odeh, I will give thanks. Odeh Yahuwah, bekol with all libi. All my heart, with my whole heart. Odeh Yahuwah, bekol libi. Isapra kol nifloteka, I will tell. Isapra of all kol nifloteka, of all thy marvelous works. Odeh Yahuwah the kol libi. Isapra kol nifloteka. Esmecha ve'elzavaka izamra shinka elyon. I will be glad and exult in thee, and exalt in the eye. Esmecha ve'elzavak. I will sing praise. Izamra, izamra. I will chant Isis. Izamra, shimka elyon. I will sing praise, Isis, to thy name is Amra Shimka Elyon, Most High Elyon, Elyon, Elyon. Esmecha we Elzabaka is Amra Shimka Elyon. The Shuva Oivaya Chora Ye Kashlua Vyovdua Mipaneka. When mine enemies are turned back, Bishub Oibayahora, they stumble, ye kashlu, and perish at thy presence. With Yobdua Mipaneka, and stumble at thy face and stumble at thy perception. Bishub Oibayahora, ye kashlu, we Yobdua Mipaneka. Ki asita mishapatiya vdiniya ya shavta le kise shofet as edeka. For thou, for the eye has maintained my right and my cause. Ki asita mishpatiya vdini. Thou, the eye satis in the throne, up on the throne. Ya shavta le kise. As the righteous judge, shofet as edek, ki asita mishpati yavudini yashabta le kise shofet as edek, edek, edek. Ka'arta goyim badta rasha, shemama machita le'olama va'eda. Thou hast rebuked the nations. Ka'arta goyim. Thou hast destroyed, downstroyed the wicked, the ratchet. Ibadta rasha. Thou, the eye, has blotted out their name forever and ever, for Ivor and Ivor. The eye has blotted out their name. Shema machita le'olama wa'edda. Ha'oyev tamu harvota la'netzach. The arima natashta avada zikramahim. Oh, thou enemy, how yev? Oh, thou enemy, the waste places are come to an end forever. Ha'oyev tamua haravota lanetzach, and the cities that thou, the eye, didst uproot, their very memorial is perished. We arima natashta abada zikramahema. Wa Yehowa le olama yesheva konena la mishpata kiso. But Jehovah is enthroned forever, for Ivor. Wa Yehowa le olama yesheva. He hath established his throne for judgment. Konein la mishpata kiso. Wa Yehovah le olama yesheba. Konein la mishpata kiso. Vehua yishpata tevela bitzedek. Yadina lumima bimesharim. And he will judge the world in righteousness. With who yishpata tevela bitzedek, he will minister judgment to the peoples with equity. Yadina leumim bimesharim. Who yishpata tevela bitzedek. Yadina leumim bimesharim. V'yehi Yahuwah misgava ladak, misgava le'itota batzara. Jehovah also will be a high tower for the oppressed, for the downpressed, a high tower in times of trouble. V'yehi Yahuwah misgava ladak. Misgaba le'itota batzara. Ve'yivat chua vika yodaya shimeka. Ki lo azabta doresheka Yahuwah. And they that know thy name will put their trust in thee, in the eye. Ve'yivat chua vika yodaya shimeka,
For thou, the I, Jehovah, hast not forsaken them that seek thee, that seek the I. Ki lo azabta doreshekai Yahowah. Ki lo azabta doreshekai Yahowah. Zamru la Yahowah Yosheva Tzion. Hagidu ba amima lilotayo. Zamru la Yahowah Yosheva Tzion. Hagidu ba amima lilotayo. Sing praises, Isis, to Jehovah. Zamru la Yahowah, who dwelleth in Zion, who is seated in Zion, Yosheb Tzion. Zamru la Yahowah, Yosheb Tzion. Declare y'all, Hagidu. Declare y'all among the peoples his doings. Hagidu ba'amim elilotayo. Ki doresha damim otama zakar loa shakachas aikata enarim. For he that avengeth blood hath remembered them. Ki doresha damim otama zakar. He hath not forgotten the cry of the humble. Lo shakach tzaikata enawi. Chaneni Yehovah rei ani mia sonai meromi mia sairei mavet. Be gracious to I, O Jehovah. Behold, Rei, behold mine affliction, Rei, Ani, at the hands of them that hate me, at the hands of them, all of them that hate I, Mia Sonai, thou, the I that liftest me up, that liftest I up from the gates of death. Me rom mia, mia sha'erei mavet. Me rom mia sha'erei mavet. Chaneni re'eya aniyya mia sonaya. Me rom mia sha'erei mavet. Le ma'ana isapra kola tehilateka. Die sha'erei vatal tzion. Agil via shuateka. That I may tell of all thy praise in the gates of the daughter of Zion, that I may rejoice in thy salvation. Lima'an isapra kola tehilateka, that I may tell of thy praise. B'sha'erei bata tzion, in the gates of bata tzion, of the daughter of Zion, that I may rejoice. Agila, Agila, Bishuateka, in the eye salvation, in the eye Yeshua. Agila, Bishuateka, Lima'ana sapra kola tilateka, Bishareya batazion. Agila, Bishuateka. Of Ua Goyim, De Shahata, Asua, De Resheta Zu, Tamanu, Nia Likdar Raglam. The nations, the nationalities, the Gentiles, the international community are sunk down in the pit that they made, in the net that they hid, is their own foot taken. Abu Goyim, De Shahata Asu. The nations, the Goyi, are sunk down in the pit. Abu Goyi, Bishachat, that they made. Bishachat Asu, in the net. Bireshetazu, in the net that they hid. Bireshetazu, Tamanu, is their own foot taken. Nia Likda Raglam. abu goyim bishachata asu bereshet zu tamanu nilikda raglam. Noda Yahuwah mishpata asa befo ala kapayo no keisha rasha higayon selah. Jehovah has made himself known. He has executed judgment. The wicked is sneered in the walk, in the work of his own hands. Higayon selah. Pause. Noda Yahuwah mishpata asa. Jehovah is made known, hath made himself known, has made himself known. He hath executed judgment. Noda Yahuwah mishpata asa. The wicked, the ratchet, is sneered in the walk, in the work of his own hands. Bit for Allah kapayo no keisha rasha. Higayon.
Selah.
Higayon.
Haga.
Meditation. Yashuvu goyima Elohim. The wicked, the ratchet shall return to the nether world. Even all the nations, all the goyim, all the Gentiles, all the international community that forget Elohim. Yashuvu rishaima lishola. The wicked ones, the rishaim, shall return to Sheolah, shall return to Sheol, shall return to the nether world. Yashuvu rishaima lishaolah. Even all the nations called goyim that forget Elohim, shekechei Elohim. All nations shall be turned into hell that forget Elohim. Ki lo la netzach. Ye shakacha evyon tikwata in yima tovada laada. For the needy shall not always be forgotten. Ki lo la netzach ya shakach evyon, nor the expectation of the poor perish forever. Tikwata. Tikwata, tikwat, tikwata, enyim, torad, laada. Kumah Yahuwah, ala yaoza, enosha, ye shaftu goyim, al paneka. Arise, O Jehovah, kumah Yahuwah, let not man prevail. Ala yaoza enosh, let not mortal man prevail. Al yaoz enosh, let the nations, the nationalities be judged in thy sight, in thy presence, in thy perception. Ye shaftu goyi al paneka, let them be judged against thy face. Al paneka. Shitah Yahuwah mora lahem yedu goyim enosha hema selah. Set terror over them, O Jehovah. Shitah Yahuwah mora lahem. Make the nations, the nationalities, the Gentiles, the international community know they are but men. They are just mortal men. Ye do goi enosh hema. Selah.
Hophni and Phinehas, yeah, the two of them, Eli the high priest sons, wreaking havoc in the temple, causing spiritual ruin. The whole congregation did want it to be done. The wrath of the Lord laid the two hands on. When he like hear it, he like them father fall down. The shock to his heart, it was not a random. In spirit and in truth, Samuel the surrogate son, one which was obedient to the ancient wisdom. Samuel hear the voice of the Lord, hear the voice of the Lord when Eli shot down. Bring the oil to David, send the anointing cherub. Who will go for up? Here am I, send me. Who will go for up? Here am I, send me. Yeah, yeah. Still small voice, Samuel fear him not sleep. High priest mediating in a wall of deep. How him hunger, Agag, the Amalekite chief. To obey is better than sacrifice, regret it in a grave. Speaking familiar spirit, prognostication speak. Decibels of resonance, I tell you, don't do it. Conscience internal, block your heart, string beat. Conscience internal, I block your heart, string beat. Who will go for us? Here am I, send me. Who will go for us? Here am I, send me. Who will go for us? Here am I, send me. Who will go for us? Here am I, send me. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Athaliah look for murder Joash, her own grandson. Daughter of Jezebel fit on the kingdom, queendom. Jehoiah the Zedek, hide the royal infant. Same thing happened to Jezebel, how she brought her Godom. All over the rulership of the Hebrew nation. When them go climb, them cut out all the wrong. When them done climb, them cut out all the ladder wrong. Make sure you stay up on the lowest ground. Bring the oil to David, send the anointing cherub. Send one obedient to the ancient wisdom. Samuel hear of the voice of the Lord, Eli shut down. Bring down the oil to David, send the anointing cherub. Bring down the oil to David, send the anointing cherub. Who will go for us? Jahira, my send me. Who will go for us? Jahira, my send me. Who will go for us? Jahira, my send me. Send me. Who will go for us?
In that relation, because the word, right, is never apart from the spirit, 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 and the korban. The korban is the offering, and the zebach or zevach. Some say zevach, zebach, zebach. I was going to do a reason on that. You know, there's one of the black Hebrew Israelites, zebach. I mean, who names their child? Well, who names himself Zavach? So that was interesting. You know, very interesting. You know, but it means actually sacrifice, right? Sacrifice. I think we went into, in the V-log, we went into a little bit of the metaphysical Bible dictionary. And I don't think those are Israelite by that name. It wasn't an Israelite. It was a Midianite, I believe so. But anyway, that's the term right there for sacrifice. So Jah didn't command them burnt offerings and sacrifices in the day that he brought them out of Egypt. It was only, as some would say, and I can agree with this in the context, as a concession, because of the golden calf, the Akri, and because the people were not ready to receive the higher type. You know what I mean? I don't know if I would call it training. It was a kind of a training, but it was also to satisfy that which already was so strongly naturally in the people, and also naturally in the world of their time. But when we compare it with what other nations were really doing or other religions were actually doing, it was so Aita, for its time compared to the others. Of course, when we look at Eitan or in that fuller fullness of the New Covenant type, King of Kings, Christ type, well, of course, this is superior to that because this is in Christ, even Christ in his kingly character type. So it's the fullest type, right? To whom more is given, more is required. But what was required of them at that time? It was a stepping stone. But it gives us here a powerful objective lesson. The objective lesson so we can learn the objective reality, as Psalm 67 says, to know thy way upon the earth, right? To know thy way upon the earth. So we have the zebach, is the sacrifice, and we have the korban, the offering, right? And the types of offering. Now, the korban, the offering, sometimes the terms are confused. I'm not going to get into the intent. You know, I really can't say the intent of people who I'm not able to cross-examine. You know, or unless I come across something where they say, hey, we knew this word was this, but we did that anyway to confuse people. Well, then we have evidence. So sometimes we kind of go off and we see a situation like this and say, oh, because they wanted to confuse people and that's why they did it. Maybe they did, but let's just deal with the objective reality of the matter. What is the true orientation of what's what? So that we can then put it in the true context and see whether we can see that in spirit and in truth. And in the true sense, we have the sacrifices. Let's go over here. So John didn't command them in the day that he brought them out of Egypt. He didn't command them burnt offerings and sacrifices. The scripture does not contradict itself. Anyone who says so based on, you know, say the prophet word from Jeremiah and then tried to point out, well, something was wrong with the sacrifices and offering. He didn't command them in that day. That's what it says. He did not, and we look at that day, some say, well, it's the Passover. That was a sacrifice. No, it wasn't. And not a sacrifice in the sense that the people were commanded to sacrifice. That was a sacrifice of the Lord's Passover. It's the Lord's Passover, his passing over, right? The purpose of that was clearly stated right there. Now here, in picking up with, coming up to the 8th, right, the priests beginning their ministry. So before the priests began their ministry, we have the consecration. That's the point there, the consecration. The consecration from the Hebrew basically means the filling of the hand. Now, this reminds me of the Kedase of the true church and the professing church of he who had the keys of great King David, the true, we could say, Orthodox, Tewahedo church in the Ethiopian Orthodox professing church, right? We have, there's a word where the priests do not bless, they cannot, in a sense, bless each other in that sense, if you understand what I'm saying, because they are the priests, right? The priests don't, but what they would do is either clasp hands and it is said the power of Peter, but this whole idea of the clasping of hands and the sense of the filling of the hands comes through when we look at the consecration of the priests. And the consecration of the priests and the high priest, right, and the fact that the priests did not consecrate themselves. I think there's a New Testament reading said that the priest, something about that, but one is called, right? The priests did not consecrate themselves. All was done by another. In this instance, Moses is the one who acted for Jehovah. The priests simply presented their bodies in the sense of Romans chapter 12, verse 1. I beseech you, I beg you, I'm begging you, I'm imploring you. If you want to use the word begging, you can use another English word. I implore you, I implore thee by the mercies, beseech by the mercies, right, of Elohim, that we do what? Present our what? Bodies. Know ye not that, you know, your body is a temple? Right? So then we have the high priest anointing. This is significant. The Constitution, Revised Constitution, 1955 Constitution, it says, I just paraphrase right here, it says, by the anointing, the anointing that he has received, of the sacred oil, that his majesty, his person, right, his person is sacred, is holy, right, and anyone, you know, who seeks to, I forget the exact wording of it, but like to injure that. So his person is very clear from the very first words right there. This is nothing that Rastaman is like, you know, I'm saying this, but if you look at the 1955, I have a copy of it, but just to kind of segue the principle of anointing. You know, could we say His Majesty's King? Yes, but the significance is the anointing. He is the anointed King of Kings upon the throne of great King David in the same country that has the yea and amen claims of the Ark of the Covenant. So, you know, putting all this together with what the Word says, Ethiopia, this man was born there, you know, and all the evidence, you know, any reasonable, you know, mind would recognize the yea and amen. So it's the anointing. Right? Just point out this anointing. And he poured the anointing oil upon Aaron's head and anointed him to sanctify him, to set him apart, being set apart, to sanctify him. Then we have the priests are clothed. The priests are clothed as well. Right? And let's see, with the priests being clothed, then the offerings. And so here we have the bullet. Now here's the footer. Two important distinctions are made in the case of the high priest, thus confirming his typical relation to Christ, the anti-type. And the anti-type, for once, you know, get all twisted about the anti, instead of type. What we have is like the shadow and then the full of full. So we're looking at the pattern. Aaron is anointed before the sacrifices are slain. While in the case of the priest, in the case of the HaKohani, the sons of Aaron, the application of blood precedes, it precedes the anointing. So let's all go over that again. Aaron, Aharon, is anointed before the sacrifices are slain, while in the case of the Kohanim, HaKohanim, the Kohanat, the priest, the application, the app of the blood, precedes the anointing. Remember, blood as a symbol, Hebraically, is life. Now, this is where there was a question, I think, John J. Parr's Hebrew Christians, was a question about how do we, or how do you, how do I and I, how do we see this whole thing about blood, if the Torah is very clear, says that we will eat no, you know, drink no, eat no blood. And then what the Messiah says, remember in John chapter 6, I think that verse 66 is that high point or low point, depending on your view, where the many ones and ones turned away disciples from following Christ because what he said, they said it was a hard thing. You know, when he said, eat his flesh, drink his blood. Even though he also said that, you know, the flesh profit is nothing, and spoke about the word, right? The word and the type of the flesh. And therefore, what about the blood? Well, the blood is life, right? So with Aaron, he's anointed before the sacrifices are slain. In the case of the high priest, there's the applying of the blood or life that precedes the anointing or the christening, the Messiah-ing. Christ, Christos, Moshiach, the sinless one. The sinless one. Because he's the word, get this, he's the word of HaElohim made flesh. He is Elohim's word. And even that right there is just a medi right there. That the word, okay, we speak the word. Look how we speak word. Right? But the Almighty, right, Father, Elohim Ha'av, spoke the word, and the word that he speak took on incarnation, even the incarnation of Kadosh Ben Mariam, the Black Madonna, Mother and I, Black Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, born of Virgin Mary. So now, Mariam also is likened in the Wadasi Mariam. That word Wadasi kind of came forward, I think, in one of the Psalms. Very interesting, even in, I think, a connection. Well, it's in the Psalm, but also in, I think, what was that, First Chronicles, where David, with Dawid, where he had set the ordinance for the first church of Zion, right? Or we could say the tabernacle of David. And this is the type, right? This is the type, right? Because what we find in the tabernacle, in the practice, was a remedial, in a sense, an object lesson to bring them to the higher type. So now the Messiah, the sinless one, the one without uchery, the one without lack, right? The one without forfeiture, right, required no preparation for receiving the anointing oil, symbol of the Holy Spirit. So what we have in the anointing oil, that sense of the Messiah, the Shemen, is a symbol, learning to read the Hebrew sign language of the Holy Spirit. So when we get to the New Testament, it says, no, you're not that your bodies, and it then says, if the Holy Spirit, it's the qualification, the conditional, of one's receiving the Holy Spirit, where Romans says that his spirit, it bears witness of our spirit. Right, and the spirit connection with the Trinity in man, right, which would be, a little more correctly, the Kiddist. Let me see what the Kiddist Selassie. There's the Kiddus Selassie and the Kiddist Selassie. See, the Kiddus Selassie is he who be who he be, right? His Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. The Kiddist Selassie is that reflection in I and I, spirit, soul, and body, that tabernacle. Right now, Mariam is that type of tabernacle fulfilling, and this is what we're going to have to touch on the Wadase Mariam, see, to bring that forward more, so we can see that fulfillment, even according to the Mariam type and the Mishkan type as well, where we get the church type, but she is virgin. Think about this for a moment. Where Shiloh had gotten, you know, defiled, and there was also Gibeon, and there was other places, there was Nob, where the sanctuary was, and finally gets to make it to where? Sion, Zion, in the time of David. And that, even into the new covenant, becomes the type, the context for the type. It becomes like, you could say, the vision. You know, the vision, right? Zion in a vision. So we have the second item is that upon the high priest only was the anointing oil poured. Note that as well. It's only upon the high priest that anointing. This is one of the reasons why Adonino said that it was expedient that he go away. And he will send the comfort to the Holy Spirit, because the Holy Spirit was poured upon him. How can you say there was there was ability for him to go, right, from the from this incarnation, from this plane right here, in order to send the Holy Spirit. And this is where, when we talk about the Hebrew Trinity, and even in Yoel Natan's book, The Jewish Trinity, seeing the Son and the Spirit, you know, in that relation, because the Word, right, is never apart from the Spirit. But sometimes the Spirit can be sent forward, right, without the Word. Remember, Word, sound, power. That Word is before sound, right? The Word exists before sound. So here we have the Holy Spirit being poured, right? Here we have Elohim did not give us not, or did not give, or give us not the Spirit by measure to him in John chapter 3, verse 34. That Ha Elohim, the true good, the true God source, giveth not Ha Ruach, the Spirit, by measure to him. By measure to him. In other words, like just a little bit now, a little bit. It's almost like how we go through the Torah portions, right? And to really be able to, you know, chew our food, you know, we have the bread for the Shabuah, the bread for that Shabuah, and it's the whole, holistically, the entirety, itality. You know, ital is vital in the sense of totality. It's the holistic, the whole that is greater than the sum of the parts, but we go through the parts. But for him, all this is one in him. Like now we're studying, say, this aspect, okay, the Holy Spirit, and take us a moment, you know, meditate upon that, you know, and then we can see the other portion, all right? So the Spirit's not given to him by measure, right, by measure, right? Now, this is interesting because one of the early church credos, the credo, 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 me credo, I amen, I admit as truth. That's what me credo, I admit as truth. Some would translate as I believe, I admit as truth, right, that the Holy Spirit proceeded from the Father to the Son. Right? Notice that the Holy Spirit proceeded from the Father to the Son. It's interesting, from the Father to the Word. Right? So His Word became flesh. Right? And in a sense, by the process of what we call the crucifixion and the types of what took place, this opened up the ability for us to receive, right, according to our measure to receive, that Holy Spirit. Right? So thy anointed, speaking about the anointed, his anointed, thy Elohim. Notice to say here we have in Hebrews 1 and 9 that connects with Psalm, I think, 45, thy Elohim hath anointed thee, Eloheka, hath anointed thee with the oil of gladness above thy fellows. Thy Elohim, thy God, thy source hath anointed thee. Interesting. His, he say, he goes to his Father, our Father, to his Elohim, our Elohim. And Hebrews 1 and 9 says, thy Elohim hath anointed thee with the oil of gladness. See, that's the state of mind there, the gladness, above thy fellows, right? Above thy fellows. So we have to have gladness, but he has that perpetual, you say, state of mind, right? He can keep that perpetual. Sometimes we might, like with Peter, example, good example is Peter. Peter saw the Messiah walk in the water and said, can I walk, come out to you? Can I walk in the water too? And he said, yes, you may. And he walked in the water. He was doing it for a moment. And then the wind started blowing, the waters and all that. And he kind of took his focus off of that mind state, and he began to sink in the waters, right? But still, at that time when he said, save me, right? And the Messiah, you know, lifted him up, right? Grabbed him from the waters, right? He still had that oil of gladness, that spirit was still there. He's still walking on the waters, right? So all the fellows, the companions, disciples, I and I can do so. Right, but his measure, of course, is greater as we see the measure of the high priest to the fellow priests who were the Christians. The Hebrew Christians were the priests. Right, so now we can't say that all Israel was anointed because that would not be true. All Israel was not anointed, so we need to ask the question: well, who was anointed? So just in understanding the whole principle of anointing, even at this point, or this point here is the Christ type, and as we go further, we'll see that priests. Right, certain prophets, right, as well as certain kings, right? Well, kings according to the Hebrew principle also. So for the Hebrews, priests, prophets, and kings were all anointed. So here we're getting another type of priest, prophet, and king. But see, instead of us saying that, well, every one of us is priest, prophet, and king, we must first of all look upon the type, the example, right? And then, as his man said, do the best in our human manifest to approximate that example. That's what it is, to live it out. Right, to live it up and to live it out, right? And that is the relationship that we have with the sons of Aaron. Think about that for a moment. You know, are we Christ's sons in that sense, like the sons' sons? No, we his brothers. He's our big brother, right? But through him, right, and the faith in him, does he give us authority to become sons of Elohim, of his Elohim that has anointed him with the oil of gladness above thy fellows. So we have that standard, you know, the destined, you know, for us by the great creator, the summit. That's why, you know, that standard, which is that summit, you know, that Zion in the vision. So just to point that out right here as well. And let's see, what else we had? Okay, the blood was applied, the anointing of the priest, right? And then the food of the priest as well, the food of the priest. Obviously, the workman is worthy of his labor, right? And then the tenth. So we have 10 items. That's also interesting. 10 items of those who would be the intermediaries, so to speak, right? Because all of Israel was not worthy, right? Because of the golden calf, right? Because of that. In a sense, what they needed to do was see a true type of burnt offering and sacrifice with even the better promises to come, right? They had to be, you would say, familiarized with a higher pattern. Right, so this is also another condescension in that sense of it, right? You know, in order, right, so that they would grow, right? And this is where we can now look at these things and not cut off the Old Testament. Just to point out that word of His Majesty, too, where He speaks about, you know, the Bible should not be cut into portions. Now, in the right context of that, it's not speaking about our Torah portion where things are studied, because even in the Orthodox Church, we have certain areas of Scripture that are studied appropriately at certain times, right, and teach us to number our days. Right, but to say that, well, hey, because this book has debtors and sacrifices in it, we shouldn't look at it because we rise too far, and we don't like some. Well, some might still have a carnal mind, you know, maybe they have a carnal mind, or their mentality, right, is carnal. That's what will be the carnal mind, you know, and growing in grace. So the 7 days, right, lead us forward to the eighth day, right, the eighth day. There's some more of the typology that we'd like to touch on, I think, a little bit more, and then the strange fire. Oh, worry. We have the strange fire also coming up. Now, the connection of that fire, right, where the priests used the flames from the altar to light the menorah. Remember, it was, you know, the fire on the altar was originally ignited by the presence or the face of HaElohim, of He Who Be Who He Be, His presence. So when you speak about the face, you might say presence. You might even use a kind of, is that like an adverb or something like that? Prepositional, like when we say before the Lord, lifne, the finai, fene, pene, right, before His face, before his presence, right? But we like to bring out a little more of the inner sense of it, the perception. We said, let this mind be in you, that the altar fire was holy fire, set apart fire, because that fire was ignited by the perception of HaElohim, and this sacred fire was never to be extinguished, never to be put out. So there'll be highs and lows, so to speak, but the fire never to be extinguished. The fire on the altar is to be kept burning on him. The fire shall be kept burning continually on the altar. It is not to go out. So that's a very important emphasis right there, the fire. There's a more fire. Because some of us may have an idea, you know, we say fire, fire, burn, fire, this, fire, that. But it's loose fire. This here teaches us a discipline, both in the 25th and coming up right here, the 26th. Shemini. I noticed before, it's the 2 and the 6. Notice that right there is 8, and here's come to 8th day, the ordination, right? The ordination. Now, in this Torah portion upcoming, I have a few interesting things. The priests begin their ministry, the sons of Aaron. But then we have the strange fire of Nadab and Abihu. We have a holy Elohim, a set-apart Elohim, to be reflected by a holy people. Now, even right there at chapter 11, the mind Zion and I was mastered about the 10 words, his advice to all, right? So we get some of the dietary, rephrase, the liberty, right? But see, this was the liberty then. Now, we understand the principles. Now, here it speaks about a lot of different animals. Even from that, we can learn, right, according to the principle. There's a principle here. It's condescension of His will, right, to the people where they are, that through this order, right, may they learn and may they grow to receive the higher type. So the principles still apply, right? Not, this is not to say that, oh, well, these sort of animals. If one were to, right, and one were to do it according to this, it is still according to His word, and there's a real principle, but there's a new way and a living way. But we just point to this right here because the liberty, their food, you know, the food, right? When we talk about the law, the change of law, and all that, this is like a change of law, right? You know, priesthood requires a change of law, but the type is still righteousness. Righteousness in and for these days. But looking through that, I'm reminded of how when the Ark of the Covenant came into Ethiopia in the Covenant of Guests, there was two first words that the Covenant of Guests records
that the sons of Zadok, so speaking about the sons of Zadok, I think Mariam Tanei in the Sacred Geometry broadcast, I think from a Shabuah or so ago, she touched on that right there, the sons of Zadok, right? Yeah, the Sacred Geometry and the pattern, right? And here we have the sons of Zadok, Azarias, you know, the sons of Zadok. And when it came forth to Ethiopia, there's two main things that Covenant of Gas records. It says that they then, when they reached the city of Makeda, right, they declared, I think, the 10 words, right? They declared, like, the Shema, the 10 words, and they declared the Levitical, what we have here, the Levitical, the Levity, right? One might say the dietary laws right here, right? Because this is from the, you can say, the lowest degree, right? And then what we have in the New Covenant is the higher degree. But this is on, like, that ground zero, right, of what is acceptable, especially when we consider, you know, the sanitary conditions. That's why there's a lot of emphasis on even health-related regulations. If you look at them isolatedly, you know, they might seem somewhat disjointed, and we say, oh, look what they was doing, or, you know, we superimpose some of these crazy views today. But if we look at it as it connected with the times that it was in, it was a very important stepping stone that, socially speaking, has fallen, humanity has fallen kind of in a sense where, in a very objective, real sense, truth sense, much of this may be required again to civilize the nations. Just at the basic. I know people talk about, oh, well, you know, in the New Testament sense, that we are talking New Testament sense. It says when those broken branches are grafted into their own vine and their fig tree. You know what I mean? See, there's a time of grace that was appointed for Israel in order that his word would be fulfilled. He gave Israel, he put Israel like on a timeout, allowed the nations, right? He turned to the nations with the Messiah, with Christ and Christianity, a lot of that came out from that. And there was some good. Let's point out there was some good to that. Often people say, well, you know, just the European, the white nation, it was all bad. Now, stop lying. First of all, it wasn't all white folks, but there was righteous black folks and righteous white folks, and there was the unrighteous as well. It's a spiritual warfare. It's been a spiritual warfare ever since it was declared a spiritual warfare. So, see, we have to stay within that mind, right, regardless of whatever time it is, but also see things contextually in this time. So here we have Shemini coming forward, just looking over this right here. Israel, it must be remembered, was a nation living on the earth under a theocratic government. So this chapter here, this Torah portion, chapter 11, one should make a reference to it, at least in your studies, you know, compare and contrast, and ask yourself, isn't it interesting? In the Covenant of Gesh, we have this chapter here, one of the first words said, when the 1,000 from each of the firstborn sons of Israel came forward with King Solomon and the Queen of Sheba's only son, Minyalik, Ibn Hakim, Bain Alechem, also known as Dagmawi Dawit, David II, came forward with the Ark of the Covenant. This was what was also declared along with the Ten Words and the Shema. This is why those are foundation. So moving forward. Yes, I.
Princes shall come out of Egypt. Ethiopia shall soon stretch out her hands unto God. Sing unto God, ye kingdoms of the earth. Oh, sing praises unto the Lord. Selah.
Shavuot Tov. A good seven. Good strong. Good sabbatically speaking. Yes, I. Shalom, Chavarim. Shalom. Give thanks.
Blessed be the Lord my strength, which teacheth my hands to war and my fingers to fight. my goodness and my fortress, my high tower and my deliverer, my shield and he in whom I trust, who subdueth my people under me. Lord, what is man that thou takest knowledge of him, or the son of man that thou makest account of him? Man is like to vanity. His days are as a shadow that passeth away. Bow thy heavens, O Lord, and come down. Touch the mountains, and they shall smoke. Cast forth lightning and scatter them. Shoot out thine arrows and destroy them. Send thine hand from above. Rid me and deliver me out of great waters from the hand of strange children whose mouth speaketh vanity and their right hand is a right hand of falsehood. I will sing a new song unto thee, O God. Upon a psaltery and an instrument of 10 strings will I sing praises unto thee. It is he that giveth salvation unto kings, who delivereth David his servant from the hurtful sword. Rid me and deliver me from the hand of strange children, whose mouth speaketh vanity, and their right hand is a right hand of falsehood, that our sons may be as plants grown up in their youth, that our daughters may be as cornerstones, polished after the similitude of a palace, that our garners may be full, affording all manner of store, that our sheep may bring forth thousands and 10,000s in our streets, that our oxen may be strong to labor, that there be no breaking in nor going out, that there be no complaining in our streets. Happy is that people that is in such a case. Yea, happy is that people whose God is the Lord.
Oh. Shabua Tov, referring to the week, or more correctly, like the seven days.
Shabua Tov, a good seven, good strong.
Sabbatically speaking, yes, I. Shalom, Chavarim, shalom. Give thanks.
Psalm 67. God be merciful unto us, and bless us, and cause his face to shine upon us. Selah. Psalm 67. God be merciful unto us, and bless us, and cause his face to shine upon us. Selah. God be merciful unto us, and bless us, and cause his face to shine upon us. God be merciful unto us, and bless us, and cause his face to shine upon us. Selah. That thy way may be known upon earth, thy saving health among all nations. Let the people praise thee, O God, let all the people praise thee. O let the nations be glad and sing for joy, for thou shalt judge the people righteously, and govern the nations upon earth. Selah. Let the people praise thee, O God, let all the people praise thee. Then shall the earth yield her increase, and God, even our own God, shall bless us. God shall bless us, and all the ends of the earth shall fear him. Psalm 67. God be merciful unto us, and bless us, and cause his face to shine upon us. Selah. That thy way may be known upon earth, thy saving health, thy saving health, thy saving health, thy saving. Psalm 67. God be merciful unto us, and bless us, and cause his face to shine upon us. That thy way may be known upon earth, thy saving health among all nations. Let the people praise thee, O God, let all the people praise thee. O let the nations be glad and sing for joy, for thou shalt judge the people righteously and govern the nations upon earth. Selah. Let the people praise thee, O God, let all the people praise thee. Then shall the earth yield her increase, and God, even our own God, shall bless us. God shall bless us, and all the ends of the earth shall fear him, shall fear him, shall fear him, shall fear him, shall fear him. God be merciful unto us, and bless us. God be merciful unto us, and bless us, and cause his face to shine upon us. Selah. God be merciful unto us, and bless us, and cause his face to shine upon us. Selah. God be merciful unto us, and bless us, and cause his face to shine upon us. Selah.
Shabua Tov, Chavarim, and good Shabua, Hashem Yeshua. Shalom.
Thank you for using Blog Talk Radio.